From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Foreign Affairs and Public Service Minister Fred Mitchell said promotions granted in the last few weeks by the Minnis administration have been temporarily halted to give the new government an opportunity to review them to ensure nothing nefarious has taken place. Last week, letters were issued stating that promotions at the Water and Sewage Corporation, which should have taken effect on September 1, were now being put on hold. Yesterday, Mr. Mitchell told the press the action was taken out of an abundance of caution. He said, quote, "What seems to have happened, looking at the actions of the last weeks of the Minnis administration, was that there was an attempt, it appears, and I don't want to say it so until we actually know the facts, to put what we call a poison pill. So the idea was that it would hobble any new administration, and two things seem to be at play. One is to offer an incentive for people to vote for the past administration, and then secondly, the poison pill, so that presumably those who were promoted or hired were supporters of the last administration and would therefore end up causing problems for the new administration." Mr. Mitchell said when he assumed his office at the Department of Public Service, he found stacks of promotions, many of which he said he suspected were long overdue. He said in view of this fact, he did not want to put a negative imprint on the situation. Prime Minister and Minister of Finance Philip Brave Davis said his administration is assessing the country's debt arrangements and will seek to negotiate where necessary to avoid default. His comments came when speaking to reporters after returning from his recent trip to the United Nations General Assembly. Mr. Davis was asked about a recent article in the Jamaican Gleaner, which said that the Bahamas was one of two countries expected to default on their sovereign debt. In response, Mr. Davis said his administration has brought back the substantial financial Secretary Simon Wilson and is now looking and assessing the country's debt arrangement to determine how best to approach it and to avoid any default. Mr. Davis added that his administration had planned to live up to the nation's obligations and stated where they are unable to seek to renegotiate the terms so as to not be in default. Police are investigating after three men died in separate shooting and stabbing incidents on Sunday. In the first incident, at around 1:30 p.m., police received reports of a shooting on Faith Avenue South off of Carmichael Road. Officers responded, and on their arrival, they found the body of a man lying on the ground outside a tire repair shop with wounds to his head that were consistent with gunshot wounds. Emergency medical services visited the scene and pronounced the victim lifeless. Police said initial investigations revealed that the victim was at his place of employment when he was approached by an armed man who shot him before fleeing the scene in a small vehicle. In the second incident, shortly after 10 p.m., police received reports of a shooting that occurred on Theodore Lane off of Tonic Williams Darling Highway. The first responding officers were directed to the body of a man lying on the ground unresponsive. And in the third incident, shortly before 11 p.m., police received reports of a stabbing that occurred at the intersection of Cordo Avenue and Lincoln Boulevard. The victim was transported to hospital via a private vehicle, where he later succumbed to his injuries. Some staff at the Bahamas Technical and Vocational Institute have issued a clarion call for the Davis administration not to consider Board Chairman Kevin Basden for reappointment. The Union of Tertiary Educators of the Bahamas, the bargaining agent for the workers at BTVI, said workers are prepared to stage industrial action over the issue. Mr. Basden, an 8-year board member, was first appointed as deputy chairman on the BTVI board during the 2012 Christie administration. He stayed on after the election in 2017 and was later appointed to the post of chairman by the Minnis administration. Over the years, tension has grown between the staff and executives at BTVI, with allegations of mistreatment and suppression of staff advancement. Several BTVI staff spoke to the Tribune, claiming that they were prepared to withdraw their service if Mr. Basden returns to the board. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, the Biden administration moved on Monday to shield hundreds of thousands of immigrants who came to the United States as young children from deportation, proposing to do so via regulation, the latest maneuver in a long-running drama over the policy's legality. The proposed rule attempts to satisfy concerns of a federal judge in Houston who ruled in July that the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program was illegal. It takes on heightened importance as prospects for legislation have dimmed. U.S. District Judge Andrew Hannon, an appointee of President George W. Bush, said the Obama administration overstepped its authority and did not properly seek feedback when it introduced DACA in 2012. The party that narrowly beat outgoing German Chancellor Angela Merkel's bloc pushed today for a quick agreement on a coalition government, but Europe's biggest economy could still be in for weeks of uncertainty after an election that failed to set a clear direction. Olaf Scholz, the candidate of the center-left Social Democrats, called for Merkel's center-right Union bloc to go into opposition after its worst-ever result in a national election. Both parties finished with well under 30% of the vote, and that appeared to put the keys to power in the hands of two opposition parties, raising questions over the stability of a future government. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service saw of Bahamas Power and Light Company. The remnants of a frontal trough across the central Bahamas will trigger showers and thunderstorms over portions of the island chain as it continues to weaken. Meanwhile, building high pressure to our north will usher in a drier regime across the northwest Bahamas through tonight. Boaters in the central and southeast Bahamas should remain vigilant due to the risk of waterspout activity. For the northwest Bahamas, it'll be mostly sunny and very warm, with a few light passing showers today, becoming fair and a bit mild tonight. Winds northeasterly at 10 to 15 knots, but gusty at times. Seas 2 to 4 feet over the ocean, but slightly higher in gusts. For the central and southeast Bahamas, it'll be variably cloudy, hot, and humid, with widely scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms through tonight. Expect gusty winds and higher seas in or near heavy showers and thunderstorms. Winds northeast to east at 10 knots or less, falling light and variable at times. Seas 1 to 3 feet over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 90 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 72. The sun will set this afternoon at 6:59 and will rise tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets, or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.